I like to call, to go further back and to call this the century of vision, because we learned to see molecules by making use of the whole wide spectrum of electromagnetic radiation. We learned to see protein molecules, we learned about their function, and we then started to make use of this new information for medicine, for drug design. A great time. But it goes back 100 years when X-rays were discovered and X-ray diffraction by crystals were discovered. That was the beginning of structural chemistry, because we learned to see atoms, of first of small molecules and later of the big proteins and DNA by using X-rays. And in the last 20 years then, we found out how to use other parts of the spectrum of the electromagnetic radiation. We learned to use microscopes in a novel way called super resolution microscopy, which extends the resolution that we have in a conventional standard microscope to the 100 nanometer range. So we start to see cells by light microscopy in rather high resolution. And then this continues. We learn to use radio waves, developing nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy as a method to visualize biomolecules. That was 30 years ago, and developed further than 20 years ago. We learned to use electrons, so the development of the electron microscope, that by applying cryo conditions, which is called cryo-electron microscopy, that was 10 years, 15 years ago, and meant a revolution in structural biology. If you now look at biochemical journals, then the top journals like Science, Nature, Cell, you find views of large protein complexes obtained by cryo-electron microscopy. And that continues. It's a great time, century of vision. And much of it happened in the last 20 years or so, and it continues. Great time, wonderful. We would like to understand biology, life processes. And for that, we have to identify the players, which are mostly proteins. And in order to understand them, we have to see them. So understanding biology is necessary, requires to see the molecules at high resolution. And this is now possible by using the Nobel methods, which I just mentioned. But of course, there is the applied side of this new information as well, allowing us to design and develop new drugs. Great time again. We are fighting cancer. I'm, by the way, on my way to Madrid to this was the reason actually for me to visit again UAB in Barcelona to speak at the CNIO, which is a center for oncology. great progress in that field as well, and progress based on structural biology and the design of novel drugs using that information. Now, we have first to identify the key players in a disease. This is not easy because of the complexity of life and of biology. We don't understand even the simplest cells. We are still in the phase where we try to isolate the key players and then analyze them in their structure and in their function. But they interact. There are thousands of these molecules in a cell, and they dynamically interact, and this we don't understand. But methods are being developed to see what happens inside cells. And again, this is a novel method which is called electron tomography, cryo-electron tomography, where we are really able at relatively high resolution to visualize whole cells and see the interplay between these macromolecules. Well, and that information then will help us to develop modulators. So sometimes we would like to activate a biological molecule. And more often we would like to inhibit it in order to combat a disease. Or think of the problem with the developing resistance to antibiotics. This is a big, very interesting field. Again, by using information that we get from basic science, then we are able to develop new antibiotics. So, what is the future? Well, of course, at the beginning, there is always basic science. We have to understand the biological process. And then, on that basis, we can design and develop novel strategies for combating diseases. So a great time again. But, I mean, cancer, for instance, is an extremely complex process. It's not a single molecule, usually not a single molecule that is not properly functioning. It's the whole system that does not function properly.